Gotta keep that butt. Rubber side. Down.
Yeah, there, ladies and gents. Just about to fit some parts to my KTM 390 Duke. First things first, I'm going to get some paddock stand bobbins fitted, which will help with doing other bits and bobs, including oil in the chain and stuff like that. So that's a really good one to stick on. And the next one I'm going to be putting on is the RNG tail tidy. I mean, it's an absolute monstrosity what's on the bike to start with, so that's got to come off. It'll also help it fit in the garage a little bit better because it will shorten the bike by a couple of inches, and my garage is rammed at the moment. Got to throw away a load of stuff. It's getting quite messy. Anyhow, let's crack on. First things first, get these paddock stand bobbins fitted. Now, fitting these bobbins is a piece of cake from what I can gather. I've done them before on other bikes, but I've not looked at the instructions for these ones yet. But they bolt straight into that hole there, I believe. It's not going to take me very long to do. And the only reason I'm shoving this on here is because I'm going to be filming, doing the tail tidy, and at some other point, the exhaust pipe. So I thought I might as well do this as well while we are here. Anyway, let's crack on. Okay, this is how they come out the box. What you have to do is take that off there, shove that in there, and shove that on the back there, and then screw them on in. They require an 8mm Allen wrench, and yep, simples, although I keep dropping it. Right. First of all, just wind it in by hand for a little bit till it's on the thread nicely. And then spanner it. Now, you don't want to do these up too tight, I don't believe, but you do want to do them up tight enough. So I'm just going a little nip on them. And I'll check them after a couple of rides to make sure they're not loosening off. The other one is exactly the same, it's just on the other side. And I don't think you need to see that. So, we'll cut to me putting it on the stand. Okay, I always get incredibly nervous putting bikes on paddock stands, especially for the first time, because you don't quite know where to hold them and how successful it's going to be. And I really didn't want you to catch me on camera dropping it as I tried in vain to put it on the stand. Fortunately, it went on a piece of cake. I had to adjust the stand a little bit just to get it so the bobbins are in line with the hooks. But yeah, that's all on there. That's cool. Anyway, the main purpose of this video is to get rid of this monstrosity here. I mean, it's just enormous. So that's the plan. I don't know how to do it. So I'm hoping the RNG tail tidy comes with some instruction and bobs. And yeah, we'll work on that now. Right. Okay, to give myself a head start, I've removed the seat, both front and rear. I'm taking out the toolbox as well. Bollocks. There we go. And one more to go, hopefully. So that seems now to be just held in by the cables. Okay, so if you see in there, you can see that the wires are pretty much the only thing holding that in, I think. And that's here on this cable tie here. So I'm gonna have to cut this cable tie and then unclip the light, number plate light and indicator wires. Okay, so that's the cable tie off. Get rid of that, put a new one on when the we put it all back together again afterwards. Okay, so now I need to find the cables for that, and that's those two there. And again, there looks to be another cable tie there, brilliant. It's nice that they're keeping the cables all tidy, but a bit of a pain in the arse at this point in trying to disconnect everything.
Okay, so I've snipped that cable tie, and now what we should only have to do now is disconnect these cables here and here. And then, so I'm guessing they're the indicators, and then this one here will be the number plate light. And that's now the lights all disconnected. So if I pull these through, doing one at a time so I don't clog it all up. There's that one. There's that one. And there's that one. Yep. Okay, so that's now the electrics all disconnected. So now I've got to work out why this hasn't just dropped off. It might be just, I think it's just friction on that. So, there we go. And that's off entirely. Okay, so that wasn't too complicated at all. Now, what I've got to do is get the indicators off it so I can reuse them on the new bracketry, which will be just a case of undoing those nuts and pulling them through, and they should just slide off. Piece of cake to do this, just tedious. There you go, and then it just pulls through. Like that, and the same for this side. Sorted, and that's everything off that. So I've got to feed all this through, but there's so much friction inside this, it's just been an absolute dick. I'm getting there, so frigging close, just utter pain in the arse. Okay, got it. This better be what the instructions mean us to do, but hey, we'll find out, won't we? Okay, now I've got to fit the indicators onto this bracket here. Okay, just for your information, really, the grey end is the right-hand indicator, and the indicator with the green is the left-hand one. So, this being the grey one, goes on the right-hand hole there like that. Okay, so I'm feeding that in there. Got the original washers back in there, and then just tying up that. Just in reverse of how we took it off the original bracket. And then with the 14mm, just give that a little nip. So now I need the self-adhesive cable clips. All I'm doing is just bending these tabs up so they don't clash with each other. And then put the last one on there, like that. Okay, so we've got that and that. Line all the holes up and shove this bung through the hole. Might be easier just to do one at a time. Might not be that hard. Okay, so that's the rubber bung holding that all roughly together. Let's push it. I think that's right. So now what we need to do is wire up this to this so that the connectors will fit onto the bike. So it's going license plate illuminator, red goes to brown, black goes to black. Simple. So red goes to brown. Black goes to black. Now apparently all these wires should fit through there, but they've not told us to fit that yet, so I'm kind of guessing we should do.
So this needs to come through here. I'm pretty sure the instructions haven't said anything so far about attaching this yet, so I'm not going to bolt it in properly. I'm just going to have it fed through that hole there. So what we've got to do is feed these wires through that grommet. There's one, and the next one. Finally, got this one to do. I would definitely have thought it would make more sense to do this a different way around. I don't think that's going to fit through there now. Oh, there it is. Just. Okay. There we go. I'm going to have to do the heat shrink on that at a later time because I haven't got a hairdryer with me at the moment. So that's pretty straightforward so far. So now these rest on there, and each of these like that. Now we need four of these and four of these. Shove them on like that, and these will go through these holes and up like that, and then bolt them back onto the bike. So let's get over to the bike. So we're back at the bike now. This is going to be a little bit of a fiddle, so I'm going to do one at a time in the hope that that makes it a bit easier. But what I'm going to do is feed these wires up through there, like a soul, and then the indicators, right there, and there. Right, so I think we're just about ready to try and get this attached, so I'm just going to lift this up and pull the cables through as we go. There, like that. And currently I'm just holding on to a cable just so I can sort of see what's going on. So I've got one in there like that. Now for this one, hopefully will not drop. That's gone through. Cool. This is going well so far. Famous last words, I guess. Okay, and one more. There we go. So now all I need to do is just tighten those up a little bit, and that should clamp it all down nicely. Not going to do them tight until I'm happy that they're all sitting in the right place. again, I want to make sure everything's in place before I tighten anything down too much, because these wires need securing and stuff as well. Right, I'm a bit annoyed actually, because at no point on the instructions has it told me to connect this in to there, which, okay, I can work out that it needs doing, but it would have probably been an awful lot easier to do that off the bike, and now we're stuck with it on the bike. Bum tits, hey? Bum tits. Oh, yeah, fiddly as fuck. Especially with the indicators there. I wish that had mentioned that before. So if you are doing this, fit this light before you fit the whole thing together on the bike. Okay. So first of all, you've got to put the washer on, but because of the angle of this, it is not freaking easy. But there we go, that's the washer on. And now I've got to try and get this tiny little nut on the end there. There we go, it's got it started on the thread. Get it round in there. Now, I don't think I've actually got a spanner small enough to do them up. So I'm going to have to do them with the pliers. It is not how you do things. Certainly not how I like to do things. So RNG really need to update their instruction manual to tell you to clamp this on. I don't think I missed it. I would have a little read through before posting this video up, because I don't want to give RNG bad jujus on something that they've actually covered and I've just not noticed. But I'm pretty sure it doesn't mention anything about doing these up. Okay, well, we're fast running out of battery on my GoPro, so what I've got to do next is tidy up these wires, which isn't going to be too majorly difficult. So this one here, there, this one there, and I've done it in the wrong way, but doesn't matter too much. This one there. And then all I've got to do is tidy up the wires on the inside by putting on some new cable ties, as we where I took them off from on the way to removing the old tail tidy, or tail untidy, as it's probably better to be referred as. But anyway, let's have a little look at what we got. Okay, so I need to tidy these wires up here. That's not going to be a problem. A couple of cable ties and re-secure all that there back onto that little loop there. That'll be cushy. And I've got to reconnect the cables up to these to make sure that they all work. Looking at it from the rear, it's so much tidier. I mean, before it would come out to about here, I think it was, whereas now it's back in there, so much shorter, much tidier, much neater. Once I fit the number plate, that'll act as a little bit of a mug guard. I'm keeping the standard mug number plate on it for the moment. I might fit a smaller one in the future, but my standard ones, I've got it, and it's got a reflect on it already and all that sort of shit. But yeah, so that's how you fit a tail tidy, an RNG tail tidy, to a KTM 390 Duke on the 2017 version. Hope you found this helpful. Also, got the bobbins fitted so I can do my chain maintenance a bit easier. And that's all groovy, baby. Groovy, groovy, groovy. Catch you in the next one, guys. Take care. Bye-bye.
Keep that bar rubber side down. Yeah, you know, you gotta keep that bar rubber side down.